What's up? This is your man Haas, Maytel Night Spots. I'm here with Trinidad James, one of the hottest names in the city right now.
Don't believe me, just watch, nigga. Don't believe me, just watch. Don't believe me, just watch, nigga. Don't believe me, just watch. Don't believe me, just watch. Gold all in my chain. Gold all in my ring. Gold all in my watch. Don't believe me, just watch.
Go Everything is really, in all honesty, man, really pushing my whole tape because I feel like the project is what I want people to know about me, not just the one song, which is All Go Everything, that's really, really going crazy. But All Go Everything is a single that's really, like, doing this thing right now.
Okay. And I was just seeing over the weekend you was with Rick Ross.
Oh, yeah, man. I actually didn't have that plan, even though it might look that way or whatever. Just went down to Tallahassee, Isle of my boy, Superstar J Quick or whatever, Demp or whatever, you know what I'm saying? Just a holler them. They reached out. Never been to Tallahassee before. My manager and them, they went to FAMU, so it was all love.
Okay.
And Ross happened to be in Tally at the time or whatever, and he was like, shit, young nigga want to rock? Why not? It's Ross. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah. Did it like that.
Okay. And what, you got a label you on, or what's your label situation?
Nah, man, I'm just doing me, man. You know, right now, I'm just doing me, grinding, pushing the tape, you know what I'm saying? And getting love off that, but no labels going on right now, boss.
Okay. And as far as locally, I seen you performed in Onyx. Was that the first time you performed in Atlanta?
Oh, no. That was the first time performing in a strip club.
Okay.
Or whatever, but I've done a few shows in Atlanta, A3C, Atlanta Indie Fest. Complex did a show for us over in Little Five Points. I did a few shows, man, actually, around Atlanta or whatever, you know. Got another one coming up this Saturday at MJQ. It's going to be crazy. Okay. Crazy. 33rds. You should come through.
Okay. Yeah, I'm definitely coming through. You got any future collaborations or anything that you're working on right now?
I mean, right now, man, to be honest with you, I'm really pushing the tape. Coming up, I mean, you know, getting ready to do my new visuals and stuff or whatever, figuring out which ones I want to do for the same tape because I want people to really be in touch with who Trinidad James is.
Okay.
By the time I'm ready to work on my next project, which won't be no time soon.
You want
to
tell them what the tape is?
It's Don't Be Safe. The acronym stands for Sensitive as Fuck Every Day. You can get it on live mixtapes. You can go to my website, trinidadjames.bandcamp.com. You can go to trinidadjamesgg.com or whatever. I mean, Google me, man. I'm everywhere. You're fun.
And you got an interesting story. Tell them how long you've been rapping for and how you got started in the rap game.
Man, every time I answer this question, the time goes a little bit longer, so I got to figure out how much time it is. It probably been, like I say, about 11.2 months.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? Something like that or whatever. But, I mean, I've always been a fan of music.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? I'm not bullshitting with the game or whatever. You know, I've always been a fan of music. And my family was always telling me, bro, you should do it because you really got the juice, what it takes to be a successful artist. And I mean, I finally really took them up on it this year. And, you know, that's where we at right now, to be honest with you, man.
Okay. Now, who are some of your musical influences coming up?
I don't know, man. To be honest with you, I've listened to a lot of music over my years. So really, when I kind of go back and listen to my music, I hear a little bit of all the artists from all the way from country music to the rappers up north, down south, west coast. That's a little bit of everything to current rappers now. It's just a kind of a subconscious take on everybody's music, but in my own way.
Okay.
You know, if that makes any sense whatsoever.
Yeah. Okay. So who are you riding around with now? Like, if I was to go into your car, who would I find?
Well, myself, but if it wasn't myself, probably Kendrick or whatever. From time to time, I just keep going back to the album.
Yeah,
it's really good. It's new, Mad, Good Kid, Mad City. Really dope album. I don't know. I mean, you might catch me listening to Chief Keef, Love Sosa or whatever. I just heard this new mixtape or whatever, I think from Pretty Boy Tank or somebody. Got a few songs in there from Future. Like,
okay.
It's really dope. I don't know, man, you just never know, bro. I never know with me, man. I could listen to some real random stuff, too. I like to listen to a lot of music with no words because I feel like music is just like it should be something like that sonically makes you feel good before you even know what they're talking about. You should automatically from the beginning, like, oh, this song makes me just feel good, you know? So that's what type of music I'm into.
Now, how would you classify your sound?
Very different, very unique, and it's like, it's for everybody. It's your universal sound, I feel, personally.
Okay.
Or whatever, as far as, like, my problems could be any man's problems or whatever, whether you're in Asia, Atlanta, West Coast, you know, the UK, wherever, you know.
Okay.
Definitely, though.
And in regards to your future, what do you see yourself 5 years from now?
I'm musically respected, man. Musically respected, staying true to myself, or whatever. What you knew me for in the beginning is what you know me for in the end. Successful, you know, some money, some change, you know, or whatever, that type of stuff. To be honest, maybe a movie, you never know, commercials, just everything that comes, all the ideas that I probably had in my life, all the things I probably said, man, I would like to do that, doing them, done them, you know?